I also had another investor tell me that he didn't do the black woman thing. So he wouldn't want to invest in my company, even though I had the platform, even though I had the market, even though I had the customers.
Tech entrepreneur Catherine Finney describes the first time she says she felt invisible while pitching an idea in a room filled with investors.
It was the first time in my life that I was met with people who had no expectations of me. It really created a space for me that was really difficult to build my company.
That's why Finney made it her mission to help women of color fund their own tech companies by creating Digital Undivided, a social enterprise that offers resources, networking opportunities, and guidance for Black and Latinx women entrepreneurs.
We don't actually care if you went to school or not. That's irrelevant to us. Entrepreneurship has nothing to do with education. It has to do with drive, it has to do with energy, it has to do with execution.
The nonprofit networking organization gained attention after launching Project Diane, named after civil rights icon Diane Nash. It focused on women of color and their involvement in the startup community.
In our first Project Diane report, which was done in 2016, we found that there was only 88 startups led by Black women. 88. Black women are approximately 20 million of the U.S. population. We also found that the average raise by those startups was $36,000. The average raise by mostly white, mostly male startups that failed was $1.3 million. So we weren't even raising enough to fail properly.
Since its founding in 2013, Digital Undivided has built more than 50 companies and raised over $25 million in investments. And now they're moving its headquarters from Atlanta to Newark, a relocation that Digital Undivided's chief of staff, Valeska Toro, says was a no-brainer.
New Jersey is great. We're very close to New York City. We have Newark Airport here. It's really easy for us to get, for anyone to get here. We have all these incredible universities. Why not Newark?
The Patterson native says Digital Undivided's incubator gave her resources and networking access that was pivotal in helping take her startup, Sola Travelers, to the next level.
For Latinas especially, when you veer off the path, everyone's like, well, what are you doing? And I think it's something that I've had to educate my family about and telling them, no, I can actually be a CEO now.
Toro says the space is focused on finding great founders first, many of whom are new to the world of startups.
If you do have an idea, you come in, we have a program, and it's we take you really from the very beginning where you have the idea to actually helping you build your business to then being able to present it to investors.
Finney says starting in December, she will be accepting applications for the organization's incubator program that will begin in February. In Newark, Raven Santana, NJTV News.